Greetings, dear seekers of wisdom. In the realm of thought, we venture forth today, embarking on a journey that takes us to the heart of ancient Greece. Under a cobalt sky, we wander through the bustling agora, surrounded by the hum of debate and discourse, our minds reverberating with the echo of age-old philosophical ponderings. We stand in the shadow of the Parthenon, feeling the weight of history in its majestic pillars. Today, we delve into the labyrinthine world of Socratic dialogues, the cornerstone of Western philosophy. It is a journey into the roots of inquiry, an exploration of the human capacity to question, and an exercise in intellectual courage. Welcome to Socratic Sojourns, Dialogues of Discovery. Have you ever pondered upon the nature of knowledge? Or wondered about the virtue of wisdom? These questions may seem nebulous, distant, and abstract, but they lie at the heart of our understanding of ourselves and the world. They are the questions that Socrates, the ancient Greek philosopher, sought to explore in his dialogues. Our journey begins with understanding the power of the Socratic method, the philosophical technique of questioning, to stimulate critical thinking and illuminate ideas. It is a dance of dialogue, a tango of thought, where the aim is not to win an argument, but to seek understanding. To Socrates, wisdom was the awareness of one's own ignorance, the humility to admit what we don't know, and the courage to question what we think we know. The Socratic dialogues, written by his student Plato, serve as a window into this world of relentless inquiry. From the Euthyphro, where Socrates grapples with the nature of piety, to the Apology, where he defends his philosophical life before the Athenian jury, these dialogues portray a man in constant pursuit of truth. In the Meno, Socrates explores the concept of virtue, and whether it can be taught, while in the Phaedo, he contemplates the immortality of the soul. Socrates is not alone in his philosophical sojourns. He is often accompanied by prominent Athenians like Alcibiades, a charismatic but flawed statesman, and Meno, a wealthy aristocrat. These characters, with their diverse viewpoints and temperaments, add layers of complexity to the dialogues, making them not just philosophical treatises, but a vibrant tapestry of Athenian society. The echoes of Socratic dialogues resonate through the works of philosophers across ages. From Descartes' methodological doubt to Kant's categorical imperative, Socratic questioning has been a guiding light. Even Friedrich Nietzsche, a staunch critic of Socratic values, acknowledged the importance of Socratic dialogues. He described Socrates as the vortex and turning point of so-called world history. In the realm of literature, Socratic dialogues have inspired a plethora of works. Umberto Eco's The Name of the Rose is a gripping detective story set in a medieval monastery, where the protagonist uses the Socratic method to unravel a series of mysterious deaths. Similarly, the play Copenhagen by Michael Frayn sees its characters engaged in Socratic dialogues about science, morality, and the unpredictability of human actions. In the contemporary world, the Socratic method continues to be a tool for facilitating critical thinking. In educational institutions, it is used to foster a culture of active learning and intellectual engagement. However, it also raises questions about the nature of education itself. Is the purpose of education to fill a mind with facts or to kindle the flame of inquiry? Is it to create conforming citizens or critical thinkers? The relevance of Socratic dialogues in today's world cannot be overstated. In an era where information is abundant but wisdom scarce, Socrates' relentless pursuit of knowledge serves as a beacon. His method of inquiry encourages us to question, to doubt, and to seek understanding. It reminds us that wisdom is not the accumulation of facts, but the willingness to admit our ignorance and continue our quest for truth. In the labyrinth of life, Socrates serves as a guide. He teaches us that the journey to truth is not a straight path, but a winding road filled with questions, doubts, and discoveries. An unexamined life is not worth living, he proclaimed, and in this proclamation, we find the essence of our philosophical journey. Dear seekers of wisdom, thank you for joining us on this journey into the heart of Socratic dialogues. Your curiosity and intellectual engagement are what make these philosophical sojourns meaningful. As we conclude our journey today, I invite you to reflect on the power of the Socratic method. How can you implement it in your daily life? How can it help you navigate the complexities of the modern world? And most importantly, how can it guide you on your path to self-discovery? Until our next philosophical exploration, remember that the journey is as important as the destination. Keep questioning, keep searching, and let the spirit of Socrates guide you on your quest for wisdom.